Hello, it's Kat, and in today's tutorial, we'll be creating this bokeh background design in Adobe Illustrator. We'll start with this free summer stock image of the beach. I'll show you how to quickly create a subtle blurred background from the image. Then I'll show you how to create this bokeh effect using simple radial gradients and blending modes. Finally, we'll put it all together to create the summer bokeh background that you see. Let's get started. Starting with the blank canvas here of 1920 by 1080 pixels, I'm going to go to File, Place, and I will import the image that I've downloaded. The link for this particular image is in the description down below, but you can use any image you like. I'm going to scale this down to 1920 wide to match my artboard and just click the align shortcuts here to center that up. I'll also adjust the height of the image here. I'm just gonna click this to unconstrain the proportions and hit 1080 pixels there and enter. And now we have an image exactly the size of our artboard. Now I'll show you a quick trick for blurring out this background so that it acts as a nice base for our bokeh lights. So we just want to select the image. You can do that using your selection tool. Click on it once and go to our object menu. Find the option called Create Gradient Mesh and click on that. And you'll see that Illustrator creates a gradient mesh from that photo and it automatically blurs out the background. Now you can change your settings here. I'm going to go with 10 rows and 6 columns and leave the appearance and highlight options on their defaults and just click OK. So that's just a nice quick way to get a blurry background that we can start building the bokeh on top of. Here's a preview of the shapes I've used to create the bokeh effect. On the top here, over the white background, you'll see 9 different circles that have radial gradients applied to them. And they may look a bit odd in this format, but once you apply the correct blending modes that we'll be using and put them over a colored background, you can see down here on the preview how they turn into glowing circles that create that bokeh effect. Let's quickly walk through creating one of these radial gradients. Go to your ellipse tool and draw a circle. I'm holding down shift to keep it a perfect circle. And now we'll go to our gradient panel here. And you can start with the radial gradient. You'll see that by default, we have white on one end and black on the other end. These are called color stops. We're going to click in the middle to add a third color stop. The important thing to note here for all of the bokeh styles is that you'll want a darker color around the edges, usually black, and a lighter color in the center. It can be white, off-white, or usually you'll see a pink or a red color. And all of these combinations work really well with the 3 blending modes that we'll use to create the bokeh effect. So let's adjust these 3 color stops so that we have the effect that you see on the left. Select your circle, and for my lightest color here, I'm going to go with a tan color. I'm setting the RGB value to 219, 204, 182. For my mid-range color, I actually want this to be black, so I'm going to adjust that to an almost black color. And I'll change the location of this color stop. I want it to be 3/4 of the way through, so somewhere around 70% is fine. And my last color stop here is already a black color, which is fine, and we will leave the location where it is, but I'm going to drop the opacity to 0%. This gives a nice feathered edge around the gradient. You can also adjust the sliders between color stops up here to decide where your colors blend. The exact settings for these gradients are something that you can experiment with. There are a ton of combinations that you might want to try. I do recommend spending some time playing around and making your own set of gradients for this purpose. I will be including a link to an AI file that has the set of gradients that I've used for this tutorial, just to help you get started so that you can dig into each one and see the exact settings. To give you a quick idea of what we have in the file, this is the first gradient that we just set up. The second one here has a few more color stops, and you can see that I'm adjusting the opacity of the actual gradient circle in some cases. This one is at 50%, and that will help add some variety to your images as well. Some of these are at 100%, and mostly they follow the same pattern. The red and pink ones you see here will not show up as red and pink when we're using the 3 blending modes that I'll show you next, and we will go into that right now. If you're not familiar with blending modes in graphics programs, basically what they do is change the way the color of your object interacts with the colors behind it. So here you can see the 3 modes we'll be using: Lighten, Screen, and Color Dodge. Each of these creates a really interesting effect when you place them over different colored backgrounds. There are plenty of other blending modes that you can try out. These 3 in particular tend to give that glowy lightning effect, so this works perfectly for creating a bokeh effect or any sort of glowing lights. So let's take a look at how we put this all together. So for my final image, all I've done here is taken a random selection of these 9 gradient circles and moved them over the image in various shapes and sizes and applied one of the 3 blending modes that we just learned about. You can see if I turn off the blurred background image that we are still working with the same colors that we built. And when you turn it back on, it will magically apply those blending modes and you'll see the glowy bokeh effect. For this image, I manually placed these circles, but you can certainly automate this process by making a scatter brush or a symbol that you can use with the symbol sprayer tool. I will cover that in a tutorial in the future, but this covers the basic concepts of how we make a bokeh effect in Adobe Illustrator. I do hope this was helpful. If it was, don't forget to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching and have a great day.